Gossip Chronicles breaking news.
Welcome to Mobster Chronicles. Joey Merlino, the alleged former boss of the Philadelphia mob, has been killing it on YouTube. Even his old foes in the media are giving him props.
Merlino's podcast, The Skinny, is really stirring the pot around town here, getting a lot of views. Your thoughts on the first month of this so far?
Well, I mean, it's pretty slick. It's well put together.
The numbers are pretty good. He's approaching 100,000 on the last views on YouTube on the last episode. He's got 30,000 Instagram followers in the first month and about 20,000 subscribers on YouTube. He is generating a following.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's a charismatic guy, and I think it's reflected in the broadcast.
The Skinny with Joey Merlino and Lil Snuff has grown to over 29,000 subscribers in less than 6 weeks, and has now surpassed all the rat channels, with the exception of Gravano and Francis. Everyone in the mob genre are tripping over themselves to jump on the bandwagon and exploit Joey's name and popularity.
Joey Merlino.
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 Joey Merlino podcast.
Joey Merlino.
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 Joey Merlino podcast.
These rats supporting YouTube vultures aren't fooling anyone with their newfound allegiance to Joey. They're just sucking up, in hopes they will score some big interview or shout out from him, and of course, to get clicks and views. Joey Merlino does not consort with rats or rat fans, or rat stooges, period. So they can keep dreaming. It's really black and white. You are a rat or you're not, and you support rats, or you don't. Most of these clowns already picked a side when they interviewed and platformed rats and snitches, so they can eat shit. They made their bed, now they get to lie in it. They are just a bunch of rat-licking clout-chasing hypocrites. And of course the rats on YouTube are leading the charge, with mutts like Dominic Sicali and Gene Borello bashing Joey and talking trash. And they even actually had the balls to call Joey a rat, a real man who did almost 20 years in prison without flipping, because scumbags like these two rodents ratted him out.
Merlino came out and stated in the beginning he was going to be accurate, he was going to tell the truth, you could believe him. Joe's already messing up, telling lies, building cases for the government. And yes, he is blowing it out of the water. I got to give him that. His views, his subs, he exploded. He exploded. But you know what? I'm going to ride his wave. Definitely. There's no doubt. I don't have to. And he keeps on mentioning me. I'll keep on coming back. Mr. Merlino wants to talk about and purport like he's the good guy, organized crime, they're the good guys, and he's going to tell the truth. Now I see why all New York City, the five crime families, are in an uproar with Joey Merlino on social media. He's still the boss. He's still active in the crime family. Joey, what are you doing? You're going to give everybody in your crime family a case. A case. You're making it easy for the government.
This next part just shows how much of a rat fuck this guy really is. And he doesn't even try to hide it.
Folks, don't worry about me going up against Joey Merlino, the big badass. I'm not worried. I'm not scared. Because I have the government behind me. Anything happens to me, all hell's going to break loose on every organized crime family out there.
Once a lying rat, always a lying rat.
Joey Merlino, for instance, right? He's on YouTube.
Yeah.
I guess I'll ask you first, what do you think of that?
He don't care about the Philadelphia Mafia because it's washed up. He don't care. Who's going to do something to him? Nobody. They're a joke. Come on, it's a quarter store gang. There's nothing going on over there. Who'd want to be a mid guy in the Philadelphia Mafia in 2023? I'd rather be a blood.
So when I said you like the show, I meant Joey's. Do you like that show? Do you think it's a good show?
I never watched it. I'll be real. I just got word that he was talking about me. And I said, oh, really? I said, okay. Listen, no New York wise guy will ever recognize him again. No one will ever sit with him again.
So you were saying earlier that he's one of us. What do you mean by that?
He's a cooperator.
How do you figure?
Because you're on YouTube talking about crime.
Even though they've already been in court and stuff.
It don't matter. You're on the internet sitting down with a show called your nickname, your mafia nickname as your show. That is a fucking disgrace. So New York, he'll never be recognized again. He's labeled a rat, pretty much. It's basically, he's the same as us now.
And of course, Joey slapped both of these clowns down.
They're using your name to get more views than I've ever seen.
That's what they got. If they don't talk about me, nobody's going to watch the show.
You're 100% right. But we surpassed all of them.
Yeah, I'm not going to talk about them. I'm not going to entertain them. That's what they want me to do.
Correct.
You know what I mean, just two things. The one kid, Gene, what's his name, Borrello?
Gene Borrello, yeah.
Yeah, he said he never hit a girl or whatever.
Yeah.
He forgot this. Tell him the story when he fucking did a home invasion and tied a 50-year-old lady up.
Wow.
He forgot about that.
Yeah, he forgot that, please.
Abuse.
Yeah. He called me fat. He said, I'm your coffee runner. Yeah.
And then...
Yeah, he don't even know me.
Fucking idiot.
Yeah, it's embarrassing.
And
it really
then,
is.
And then he said... what else did he say on here? He said something about... Oh, Italian families.
Yeah.
When you go to court, all mothers stand up for you, you know, like... His mother, he made the mother beg. He made the mother get up and beg.
Yeah.
I had five cases. My mother came. My one trial was 4 months. She came every day.
Yeah.
I ain't going to make my mother get up and beg.
Yeah.
Mercy.
Absolutely.
He did. He's a punk. And then the other guy, Dominic, what the fuck's
Dom,
his name?
Dom, I don't even know. Dom Cacalli or something like that.
He robbed his grandmother for $189,000.
Wow.
She lost the house.
Signed it right over to him, right?
So I wonder if she went for a sentence and spoke up for him.
Yeah,
nice guy, robbed his grandmother.
You know what it is? It's just hate because we surpassed them in views, subscribers.
Yeah, well, I'll never talk. This is the last time
we're
talking about
We're done talking about
fucking,
them.
Them two fucking misfits.
Yeah.
And he says if he was talking with a thing, Witsack jail.
Yeah.
They put you with the terrorist. If he ever went to a real jail.
Yeah.
If they ever went to a, they go to a special unit, like it's all rats, whatever.
Yeah.
With this protection program. Ralph Natale had video games in the fucking cell.
He's playing Nintendo.
Yeah, Nintendo in the fucking cell.
Yeah.
The FBI used to bring him all stuff. I got the phone calls.
Yeah.
To call him up, baby, bring me electric razor, anything you want.
It's amazing.
If they went, they go to Fort Dix, they go to Lowe's, they go to special housing units. If they ever went to USP Beaumont, USP McQuarrie, USP Marion, the both of them in 1 month would be pregnant.
Yeah.
That they would get abused.
Jesus God.
Pregnant.
Yeah.
They ain't got a shot. They wouldn't have a shot.
No. Yeah. Well, it's jealousy. Yeah. If they don't put your name in the captions, they would never get a view.
Nobody's going to watch
So that's it. We're done with
we're
them.
We're done with them.
Jealousy, forget that.
Jealousy's worse than cancer.
Exactly.
How can the government actually use scumbags like these guys as prosecution witnesses? It just goes to show you the widespread level of duplicitous hypocrisy that is sometimes prevalent in the justice system, or more appropriately named, the injustice system. And Joey Merlino has been a target of this conduct for decades now, and unfortunately he's not alone.
Tell me where it took place at the RICO case that you got, where they say you threatened the FBI.
No, that wasn't a RICO case.
Oh, that wasn't a RICO.
No, I got locked up for the RICO case. So we go to the bail hearing, and my lawyer said she could bail. When we get up, we go for bail, the Barry Gross gets up, and he says, we got new charges against Mr. Merlino. New charges. My lawyer's like, what? Threatened to kill an FBI agent and his family. I'm like, what the fuck is he talking about? Judge said that's serious charge, which it is, you know.
Yeah, of course.
No bail.
To see the rest of what happened, please watch Joey's video by clicking the link provided in the description section of this video, or watch our next video, where we'll show you what happened and also further expose how unjust the justice system really is. Please subscribe to Joey's YouTube channel The Skinny with Joey Merlino and Lil Snuff. The link is in the description section of this video, and help in the fight to combat the rat infestation here on YouTube. Mobster Chronicles is a syndicate of mob experts and insiders who present unique, fact-based videos and discussions about organized crime in the US and Canada. We present the mob's point of view on organized crime, with an unbiased eye and don't take cheap shots or pass any judgment on those involved. We also expose those wannabe gangsters and frauds who dare to lie about their life and connections to La Cosa Nostra in America and those snitches, stoolies and rats, who did the crime but couldn't do the time. All are targets, and none are safe from our pursuit. Mob liars, snitches and wannabes. You can run, you can lie, you can snitch, but you can't hide. Please subscribe to our channel if you want to see more content like this, hit the like button and don't forget to ring the notification bell, and we welcome your comments. Thanks for watching.